What actually is metering?
I think that this is an excellent lens.
Well, hello everyone, and welcome back to my channel. My name is Emma, and today I'm going to talk you through each of the metering modes on the Nikon Z6II. Now, I think that these modes are pretty standard to a lot of other cameras, certainly to the rest of the Nikon Z lineup. So if you have a different camera, this should apply to you as well, but specifically, I'll look at the Z6II. So first though, before I get into that, what actually is metering? Well, the title comes from the use of a handheld light meter back in the old days of photography when cameras didn't have built-in light meters and photos couldn't be viewed immediately. Photographers relied on the light meter to tell them what the exposure was. Now, of course, cameras all have a light meter built into them, but there are some situations in which photographers today might still want to use the handheld version. So, just like the purpose of a handheld light meter is to help the photographer choose the correct exposure, the purpose of the built-in light meter is to help the camera choose the correct exposure. DSLRs and mirrorless cameras generally offer several metering modes, which change how the camera evaluates the light in the scene and how it selects the correct exposure. In all but manual mode, this exposure that's chosen by the metering mode goes into the final result of the image. However, in manual mode, you of course select the exposure yourself. But the camera has an indicator, usually at the bottom of the viewfinder with little bars on it, and it shows if the image is too bright or too dark. And changes to the metering mode actually change how that little meter displays. Now, the modes that I have on my camera, there's four of them, and they are matrix metering, which I think that Canon calls this evaluative metering. Center weighted metering, spot metering, and highlight weighted metering. The default mode is going to be the matrix metering, which is probably what you will find yourself using most of the time. When you use this mode, the camera will measure the light in different locations around the frame, giving extra weight to wherever your focus point is, since that's where the subject of your photo is going to be, and then it will calculate the correct exposure from that. Now, the center-weighted metering, on the other hand, just evaluates the light from the center of the frame, regardless of where you've set the focal point. So that can be helpful if you're taking pictures of something that is backlit, the subject is in the center of the frame, the light's behind them, maybe a sunset or something, and you want the center of the frame to be exposed correctly. Or if you want to maybe expose on the center while focusing somewhere else. To be honest, I actually don't use that mode particularly often, but it is there as an option. Occasionally I'll pull it out. What I tend to use more though in these kinds of situations is the spot metering mode. This mode evaluates a small area around the focus point. This works well in backlit situations too, but it does so regardless of the placement of the subject. They don't have to be in the center of the frame. It's also good if you want to ensure that a small subject is correctly exposed and don't quite care as much about the exposure elsewhere. On my Z6II, I also like to use spot metering with the eye tracking autofocus mode for sort of those casual family photos, and that way the camera will very quickly find the eye or the face and also expose for it. Now, I'm not a portrait photographer at all, so that might not be the correct technique, but it's really quick and easy for me to use on like birthdays and other occasions. Finally on this camera, I have highlight weighted metering. Now, not every camera has this option, but what it does is it chooses the correct exposure for the highlights, which are of course the brightest spots in the photo. I find this to be very helpful actually in my landscape photography, which is primarily what I like to do, because it will automatically focus or automatically expose rather on the sky, which is usually the brightest part of the photo, and so that way I can make sure really easily that the sky is not overexposed without having to mess around with it. So how do you select the correct metering mode for whatever you're shooting? Well, if you're not sure what you want on a DSLR, the easiest way to figure it out is to snap a picture and then see how it looks. If you're not happy with it, you can delete it, change the mode, and try again. On mirrorless cameras though, the screen and the viewfinder are actually showing you a live preview of the current exposure based on the metering that you have selected. So that makes it super easy to open up the modes. Here they are on my Z6II under the I menu. And then I can rotate the rear dial between them. As I do that, you can see the image on the screen will change to reflect the new metering. So what I'll typically do is leave my camera on the matrix metering, unless I know that the light's a bit tricky. And then if the photo on the screen doesn't look right to me, if it's not quite what I wanted, then I will just flip through and try out some of the other ones. You can do the same sort of thing on a DSLR, just with some test photos, but that's the nice thing about mirrorless cameras, is they just make that a bit easier. Now finally, what if none of the metering modes quite fit? Say matrix metering maybe is doing the best job, but it's not quite what you had in mind for the exposure. Well, this is where the exposure compensation comes in. On my camera, this is controlled by pressing this little button here next to the shutter, and it allows you to adjust the metering up or down by a few stops. Anything you have fixed will stay the same. So if I'm in aperture priority mode with a manual ISO, then the aperture and the ISO are gonna remain unchanged. But the shutter speed will be adjusted to be, making the photo slightly brighter or darker than what the camera has automatically selected. So that's really helpful to fine-tune the exposure on the fly without changing over to manual mode and having to go through and pick out all of those things yourself. So that is going to be all for this video. Hopefully it helps you to understand your camera's metering modes a little bit better. If you did enjoy this video, don't forget to hit the like button on your way out and to subscribe to the channel so you don't miss more videos that I am really excited to share with you in the future. As always guys, thank you so much for watching and I will see you in the next one.